to be famous. I love doing what I'm doing, and I never want to do anything else ever.
I was a bit bored in America because I hate it when it gets into a routine. I hate that. I just think, might as well do a 9-to-5 job.
I feel responsible that I feel that I'm doing this not just for me, but for them as well now.
I was happy in America with just the four of us. I thought that it worked very well, but I did lose a friend.
The lady downstairs told me that they were here on tour, so I come up here and see if they could give me their autograph. I've never met anybody famous before, that's why I want to meet them. I liked them ever since they first started. Spice Girls.
Oh, what's that, a rock group or something?
Coming from England, I think.
Hello.
Hello.
We've arrived.
There you go.
Finally. Thanks.
And I wore my top especially.
Thank you.
Very American.
Very American.
Thank you
so much.
All right.
Bye.
So we're here now.
We're here in Miami.
How long was the flight? 9 hours.
So we feel really good.
9 hours.
Well, those are the girls. What are they calling them? The Spice Girls? Well, they're performing tonight at the by the fairgrounds. I don't know whether they'd let you guys in. They're sold out. You know, they're like the Beatles. Remember the Beatles?
It's like spending your life.
Usually, if you have too much chroma, that's the least your
fine,
worries,
fine.
You know? That's what you're saying, right?
Yes.
Yeah, we can take it down.
What else can I do? Are there any suggestions from audio that you can offer me?
No.
Hello? You sit down.
Would you like to? Absolutely.
Yeah. Chairs,
can we get some chairs, please?
Okay, girls!
Hey! Hello.
With Geri leaving the group only 2 weeks ago, did you folks have to go into overdrive to get ready?
We actually had 2 hours before one of the shows in Oslo that we got the show together, and the show went absolutely fantastically well. So we have had a little bit of extra rehearsals, but you know, we're very proud of each other. We worked hard.
All right, let's move down to you, because now I hear like you're dating some guy you dated when you were in fifth grade or something. No?
You need to do your research again. That's completely wrong.
Really? Who is it? Who are you dating now?
Somebody. Very nice man. Bye.
You're not giving it up, are
no,
you?
No, I'm not.
I'm going to see my role models performing, doing what they do, and something that I would love to do, and something I love them for doing. I want to see sparks and fire and yelling and music, everything. They're just amazing. Everything they do is what I'm here for.
$45 a head they paid here. This is sold out, just like so many of the other 39 cities that are out there. They sold out almost immediately as soon as the tickets went on sale, because people have been waiting for this, and it was after that that Ginger said no more. So now 80% of the Spice Girls will be performing tonight, and we'll see if they have the staying power to make up for that missing 20%. Back to you.
Do you think you are?
on tour was, more than anything, was a relief, I think, because when you want to do music, you want to write music and you want to perform, that is all you want to do. You just want to be on stage singing your stuff. But to be in the music industry, it's just not like that. And what you really want to do, you don't get much chance to do. You know what I mean? You spend a lot of time doing promotional trips and, you know, a lot of TVs when you'd have to mime to... And it's just... It's still fun. The whole thing is fun. But to finally get on tour is what it's all about, really.
It's like spending your life in a world, you know, that you know really doesn't exist. You know, it's completely different to what you're used to at home. You're told where to be at a certain time, but you're looked after constantly. You know, you look after yourself as well constantly. You have to, like, you know, try and keep out of trouble if you can. And it's a world that when you actually do get back home, it's sometimes very difficult to, you know, to readjust back into the world that you know at home.
There wasn't enough time on the plane to be able to sleep. All it was, you could just get on and eat. It kind of destroys your skin and kind of makes you dehydrated and more tired, I think. We could travel on the bus. I mean, sometimes I went on the bus. It was actually quite enjoyable because you get to have a sleep instead of, like, a 40-minute journey, then get up and then go and sleep. It's when, once you're on the bus, it might take you, what, 12 hours to get somewhere, but at least you're on there for good until you arrive.
Let's go hit Orlando.
Oh. There's a rat in your bum.
Gotta go with the flow, you know. No bum shots, please.
Radio Disney, just playing Mark and Zippy on our quest to meet the Spice Girls, and we've met them. Hello!
Hello!
Hi.
Now, first of all, I want to ask you guys, what's it like to be a Spice Girl?
It is really good fun. You know, that's one thing that we always have. We go to lots of countries, you know, meet lots of different fans, and, you know, we just have a good time, don't we?
Me and Mel C are usually higher. Then you've got Victoria and Mel who do middle, and also Mel B does low, and Joey also
he's
does
a soccer player.
Yeah, actually, he's playing one, the World Cup.
Two. Is he really?
Yeah.
Are you going to be... Well, no, you're not going to get to see any of it at all.
No, I mean, you know, me and Melanie watch it on the television.
Nice girls, though. I think they dug us. Do you think they dug us? I hope so.
But it's tough on today, right? And I thought, oh, you know, Americans will love that USA because I've got this really important press conference. And we get there and it's a press conference for South America. It's not even USA, is it?
Good evening, USA.
So I went down there, yeah. And I got given an Argentina top, which didn't go down well.
Exercise 10, 9-note scale.
The trouble with touring is that when you're on stage, you do forget to use all your technique, you will forget. But if you have a basic foundation, those nights when you think, oh God, I can't hit that round, I can't hit that note, you can draw on all your experience of working your diaphragm to get your notes out. You know, you can draw from all those things to help you through that gig, and then the next gig, and then the next gig. Each one of those voices has a separate character, and you have to work within that the capabilities of that person and that part of their character, of their voice, and pull out the best you can from that part of their voice. And from the beginning of the tour, you know, it's not been an easy job with the girls. They're all in rehearsals. They're all bubbly and lively, and I'll go, come on, girls, we've got to do this now, we've got to do this part, and sometimes it's quite a bit of a task.
This is my new costume.
I didn't realise actually how flary this was. We all match now. In fact, red, look, Rastafari.
Baby needs to burp.
Red. Red, gold, and green.
Okay, fantastic.
What did you do?
This is for my ears.
You push her out.
So I can hear exactly how really well I'm singing or not. It's quite interesting bit of information here. Usually I have one earpiece, but because the crowd are screaming so loud, they're screaming at 110 decibels tonight. So I have to have two.
This is our security Andy, and he's got burn. Andy Lobster. Ready, ready, red legs, we call him.
But we'd just like to show you Brother Vernon in the back.
Brother Vernon in the back.
Brother Vern. And then we got JP Brits Abroad.
Brit Abroad, JP.
Brit Abroad. Hey! Hey!
Emma?
Who knows all the latest Chaz and Dave songs?
There's about 80 people, 12 trucks, 9 buses. That's a lot of people to move between city to city. When the trucks arrive in the morning, at 8 o'clock in the morning, you know, it takes from 8 o'clock in the morning till 4 o'clock in the afternoon, 4:30 in the afternoon to get everything ready. I mean, it's on a very strict schedule, so, I mean, anything can happen. You know, equipment breaking, you know, just basically the timing not going right, things not going in the right order as it should do. There's very little margin for error in the day.
Remember doing our makeup that time?
Pat McGraw.
You and what you have to say.
The thing is, like, anytime somebody tells you something, like, it's
one of this is MTV. Yes. I like this.
Do all men use urinals or do some of them go in toilets just to pee? I couldn't get me geared out in front of a complete stranger. Do you know what I mean?
Sometimes I'm up till 4 o'clock in the morning because it is so hard just to sit in bed and say, I've just done a show in front of 18,000 people and I'm going to go to sleep now. It's like, you know, it's very hard. Only us four get that high on stage that nobody can ever understand. You know, this amazing sort of high from all these kids and they're singing your music.
We've always wanted to be on Sesame Street.
Sesame Street. We'd like to do Friends. What other stuff? We'd like to do other movies, wouldn't we?
Yeah. Yeah. Mel wants to do Baywatch.
It's because I've got such huge breasts.
He's got a
mask on and a white face. Shut the door and lock it. You're gonna miss it.
I have a different relationship with Victoria where I love her to bits. I love her to bits. You know, I can sit there and, you know, and we just chat. And same with Mel C as well. We'll go out shopping or go and, you know, she'll take me out on adventures, which is quite nice. She'll make sure I go and sunbathe down the beach or, you know, stuff like that, where me and Mel B would sit in bed all day. You know, so you have different relationships, which is really nice.
Hello.
Last night, after me and Victoria watched a really scary movie, I had to, you know, because you were watching, I had to take her up to bed and check all of the every cupboard and everything.
Well, I went to Disneyland yesterday, Disney World.
The biggie.
And it was wicked. Is this our car here?
No, I'm in the bed.
Gonna say. Who is that?
Oh, yes, our limo. Oh, no, our bus.
How long have you been
annoying people? I've been here for about 12 years now. Yeah. And I've been in the spice bubble for about 14 months, as we're now in August. And it's great, you know, it's protected by all this amniotic fluid in the spice bubble, and you just bounce around in it, and, you know, you're protected. It's great. You never have to think about the real world. You never have to go to the supermarket. You never have to make your bed. You know, that's great. I love it. May it never end. Long may they reign and employ me.
Well, so what are you doing there?
Football.
The World Cup.
JP's the master phone technician at the moment. The old ones just couldn't do, couldn't call home or couldn't call anywhere. And some of the other phones that we had was just wouldn't call in certain states. And I think when you're with these girls, they need to call anywhere, anytime, anyhow. So we've got new phones.
And that is it, because they're going to sweat a lot, you see, so you can't put a lot on them. Done. More lashes, though. The hard bit is making everything stay. So, like, a day for us is getting up, we all go down the gym, and then we all get on the bus, we go to a studio, so we make them up for the studio, which is normal makeup. And then we come to here, to the venue, and it's all hot and stuffy. And then, you know, you just kind of take it off, start again, or pile more on, and make it stay for the actual show.
I want to go home.
Bye.
Emma, look, well done. Emma.
Hi.
Oh, that's lovely.
Why do you want to go home? I'm fed up now.
Well, let's cry.
Enough now.
Get some tears out.
Yeah, get some tears out for the camera.
Home soon.
10 weeks, 35 shows.
That's ages away.
No, it's not. Look, see this? This is America, right? We've done this bit. We've got to do that bit. Have we really got all that to do?
No, don't get me wrong. I love it, but I want to go and have a barbecue in my garden with my mum.
Tell you what, should we organise a barbecue tomorrow?
Hello.
Come
Hello.
In.
Yeah. Melanie, look at my foot.
That looks nice.
Yeah, I like it. I did it myself.
That is lovely. Tell you who's got that in stenciling.
Not Madonna.
Is Naomi Campbell on the catwalk.
We are living the Spice World, really.
There's a kind of
I mean, we don't come across anybody
universe.
Else at all. you know, the hotel we're in for that day, literally a day, and the crew at large, which is about 80, 90 people.
Yeah.
And us lot, we're a core group of about 10 people, and we travel together and do everything together, and that is our world. And, you know, the only contact we have with our own lives is on the phone, really. And that's it for 6 months. We've had 2 weeks off in between, 3 months and then a block of 3 months. But at least on the European leg, we could, like, go home and just go home, even if it was for the night, then it was just brilliant. You know, we were all so excited, oh, we're going home, you know. And, but now it's, we're not going home for ages. It's like, we're counting the days.
Vindaloo is the best what you said. Yeah.
Wicked, isn't it?
I like the three lines.
Three lines went straight at one, didn't it?
Did it? And it was.
It's amazing, isn't it? I've lost interest in it. It's been really
interesting. Come on, England. Great. Scott! Got it!
What happens, right? Say we lose this. Have we got to win the next one to get through?
We've got to beat Colombia to go through, and then we'll go through in second place then. That means we'll play Argentina in the next round.
Nice. Snap goals.
No.
Come on! He's too sexy to let in a go.
Me and Melanie went to a football match, and my mum and dad were there. And someone got a goal and they aimed it up at our box to catch me or Melanie. And we sat down and my brother was watching telly at home and all you could see was my dad stood there stuffing his face full of sandwiches. And I just did a shot, some bloke eating sandwiches for like no reason.
What was the score? That was a draw in the end, wasn't it?
Wasn't that the Liverpool game?
Was
oh
it?
Yeah, 0-0, wasn't it?
Neville Hall plays it back. Beckham swung it inside. This portion of the match brought to you commercial.
Oh, hey! Oh, Beckham, come on, let's go.
So what happens if we draw this game, Richard?
Oh, no!
Oh, my God.
Always wanted to live here from the first time that I came here about 2.5 years ago. It's just the place. It's so cool here. Really, it's like so down to earth and urban and raw. It's not like your LA where it's all a bit false and tacky. Here's like the street people, real life people. I just want a studio room where I can have a bed there, kitchen there, nothing like major, because I've got that in London. So I just want somewhere where I can come and just chill out. This is the place.
This is it.
So how many people live in this block of buildings?
Probably about 20.
20? Oh, it's not too many people.
No, this is it. This space is west, so you get very good light for most of the day here.
Okay.
And it's very sunny. Moving on.
This used to be two rooms, I don't know.
Did it? What's this then? What is this? Heater, air conditioning.
This here and in there. Oh.
That?
Yes.
Is that like an air conditioning box?
Yes.
And this is another bedroom.
This is another bedroom. This wall, though, is not structural. So this could be taken down and you